Yeah, hello students, this is hard to tell one. Today this is inverse trigonometry function. So let's start. Cartesian plan. I already deduced that sine inverse alpha alpha will be n pi plus minus minus 1 to the power n theta. Theta can be any angle in the in any quadrant. This is the first, second quadrant, third quadrant, and this is fourth quadrant. This is I have already deduced in one video. Today we will deduce cos inverse alpha. So sine inverse alpha and cos inverse alpha, both principal value lies between minus 1 to 1. And both sine inverse alpha and alpha, cos inverse alpha lies between minus 1 to 1. So now to deduce cos alpha, first we take that theta cos makes it angle theta with the positive x axis, then cos theta will be some value. I think I let that this is alpha, which is between minus 1 to this is the range where cos theta exists. Now cos is positive in first and fourth quadrant. For the second quadrant, cos is negative. If I draw this, if I take the angle theta here, then this will be what? Pi minus theta. This will be pi minus theta. So what will be the value here? This will be negative cos pi minus theta equal to minus alpha, means minus alpha. Even since the second quarter theta is negative, so and when it rotates fully and comes at fourth quarter, then it will be for cos two pi plus minus theta will be alpha. So this is the giving negative value. I am erasing this. This is not necessary. So cos, because if the three angles makes here theta clockwise or anti-clockwise in both the quadrant, cos is positive. That's why we will get positive alpha. So now if we will continue in this way, cos 2n pi plus minus theta is equal to alpha, where n belongs to rational numbers. Clockwise rotation or anti-clockwise rotation for both this happens. Set of integers. So what will get cos inverse alpha? Cos inverse alpha cos inverse alpha is equal to 2n pi plus minus theta. So this is the general or all the values of cos inverse alpha, cos inverse alpha. All the values, if we put n, or n belongs to integer, if we put all the values of the n, all the values under the cosine function gives alpha. So this is the general form of cosine, inverse of cosine. So you have to remember this. Now let's see for 10. You know that 10 is positive, this is first, this is second, this is third, and this is fourth. We know that 10 is positive here, first quadrant and fourth quadrant, third quadrant. So if the angle is made here theta, first quadrant, or in the second quadrant, theta plus pi, theta plus pi, this is totally theta, pi plus theta, both are giving positive values. So 10 if 10 theta is equal to 10 pi plus theta plus 10 2 pi plus theta all the values if we take clockwise or anti-clockwise 10 n pi theta all have same values. If this is alpha, we take say alpha say, then we can get the general form of 10 inverse alpha. Is equal to n pi plus theta. So This is we are getting in general form by n belongs to the n belongs to the set of rational numbers. If you will take negative also, if you will take negative also, means clockwise direction, clockwise rotation, then also you will get n minus pi plus theta. This is also clockwise rotation. This comes also in this way pi and again my plus theta means clockwise rotation, anti clockwise rotation. First clockwise rotation, anti clockwise rotation. Then we will get this angle. So this is also in the third quadrant. So this will be also this also give the value alpha because this angle comes in the third quadrant. So n belongs to the set of integers. It is true for all integer value plus 1, minus 1, plus 2, minus 2 for all. So this is the general form. So where 10 alpha belongs to 10 inverse alpha, we know that the 10 theta always is the zero to infinity. So zero to infinity will be its range. Zero to infinity will be its range. 10 inverse alpha. So in this way we can deduce the general inverse general inverse function of tangent by in this way. In this way, quad can be deduced. I am just giving another more secant, where sec is defined. Sec are positive in the first and fourth quadrant. First and fourth quadrant. So if this is theta and this is also theta, then sec two pi plus minus theta will be some value alpha I am saying. So say any clockwise or anti-clockwise rotation, say 2n pi will be plus minus theta, where n belongs to the set of rational set of integers will be alpha. So sec inverse alpha will be 2n pi plus minus theta. Sec theta belongs to from one to infinity. So 1 to infinity will be the its range. 1 to infinity will be its range. This way cosec can be also deduced. So I have completed to evaluate the inverse trigonometric function. I think you have all understood. And if you like, then subscribe this channel to get all these videos. Share with your friends and also of course comment me if you have any problem. I must try to solve it. Thank you. Thanks for